Although they are less abundant than nitrogen and phosphorus in the Earth's crust, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth were isolated before the nitrogen and phosphorus were obtained as free elements. Some compounds containing arsenic, such as the poisonous sulfide minerals, opiments, and realga, were widely known since antiquity. In this sense, arsenic, along with antimony, were some of the elements that attracted most interest to the alchemists in the ancient times. Both elements were symbolized by alchemists as a venomous snake in the case of arsenic and a wolf for antimony, to remark that the former was a deadly poison while the latter was a metal which can devour other metals to form alloys. Although both elements were known from ancient times, the first evidence of isolation of the metals happened some years later. The discovery of arsenic is credited to the German philosopher and theologian Albertus Magnus in 1250, who described obtaining the metal by heating the mineral opiment with soap. The discovery of antimony, on the other hand, is something confused due to the vague and misleading descriptions of the alchemists. Although it was fairly credited to the Benedictine monk Basil Valentine, according to the description in the book The Triumphal Chariot of Antimony in 1492, there is some controversy about the identity of this monk, and apparently it could be another of the wholly fictitious great names of the alchemy. In fact, there is now agreement between historians that this book was likely written after the middle of 16th century by Johann Soth, who was fairly thought was the editor of that book. According to that, it would be then an Italian metallurgist, Vannoccio Beringicchio, who should be credited with the discovery of the element because it gave a detailed description for isolating the element in his book, De la Pirotecnia, in 1540. The other element described in this section, bismuth, it was also known as a metal during the 15th century by alchemists who believed that it could be transformed to silver due to the fact that it was always found in layers above silver deposits. As it happened with his congeners, the date of the first isolation of the element is shrouded in mystery. Additionally, bismuth has been long confused with tin and lead, and its discovery was not well documented until 18th century. A French nobleman called Claude Jeffet is usually credited as the person who first isolated the metal in 1753. The three elements are commercially obtained nowadays from their mineral sulfide ores, although all of them also occur in a lesser extent in their elemental form. Arsenic is industrially obtained by smelting, in the absence of air, iron arsenide, or arsenopyrite, which is an iron arsenic sulfide of silvery white aspect, which contains about 46% of arsenic. Arsenic is obtained as a vapor, which is condensed as a solid and subsequently collected. Antimony is mainly obtained from stibnite, antimony sulfide, employing scrap iron as reductant, or alternatively, mainly from the low-grade sulfide ores, can be firstly converted to the oxide and subsequently reduced to the metal with carbon. Finally, the extraction of bismuth from its sulfide ores consists in roasting to the oxide and then reducing it with iron or carbon. Alternatively, it is very important the isolation of bismuth as byproduct of lead, copper, tin, silver, and gold during the refining process.